Hello everyone, this is Sandeep Sharma here. It's very cold and there is a small thunderstorm going outside, but I know that a bigger thunderstorm has just passed from your professional life. You all gave NEET exam and I do hope that you have done well in the exam. So this is a small video I'm putting. It will have three parts. Number one, I'll be talking about my analysis of the paper based upon the inputs given by you people only. Secondly, I'll be answering some common queries. And third, we'll be talking about what next you should be doing. Of course, you should be sleeping and enjoying your life, but what next you should be doing regarding your long-term goals and profession. Just my advice, you may or may not take it. So first of all, regarding the paper, the paper has been submitted, so stop worrying about the exam. It was a lengthy paper, no doubt about it. It was a clinical oriented paper, no doubt about it, and it was a tough paper as compared to previous NEET. Having a tough paper is always good. A lot of students ask me, sir, why do you say that having a tough paper is good? See, if you are a hardworking student and you get a tough paper, if your concepts are good, the margin of error becomes wider. Whereas in an easy paper, even the people who have not good concepts and who are just relying on one-liners and coming with cramming up facts, they tend to do better. I have experienced it personally. When I was an intern, I gave AIIMS exam. It was a very easy exam, exceptionally easy exam. Despite me scoring 75%, I could not get a clinical seat in the first attempt for the simple reason because 98 other people had scored 80% or in that range. So despite me getting 75% in AIIMS, I could not get a seat. The reverse thing happened in subsequent exams I gave, including PGI. The exam was very tough. It was tough for me also and for others also. But because my concepts were good, and so I did better than people who were just relying on one-liner. So if it is a clinical paper, if it is a less repeated paper, you always have a better chance only if you are a hard-working student, because you can take calculated risk and the margin of error which you can make is wider. In an easy paper, one small mistake, there is a lot of clustering, one small mistake makes you go out of the race. So a tough paper is not always bad when it comes to a good student. So this is regarding the general paper of the pattern. Now the reality check for you, it was tough paper, but please be clear that it was not unsolvable. There are some areas, some subjects which I have just compiled, and I could see that they were actually very easy. Most of them were solvable and most of the questions asked in them, you could easily have a strike rate of more than 90%. Pediatrics, my own subject, it was very easy. PSM, radiology, half of medicine. Yes, half medicine was tough. Medicine was huge in amount, but rheumatology part was expected. Neuroanatomy, pharmacology, except two or three drugs. Biochemistry, physiology, they all were on expected patterns. There were difficult areas, I agree. Scores were there, retroperitoneal tumors were there, Monica was there, emergency medicine, B12, thyroid, close options, long cases were there. So yes, there were difficult things, there were easy things. There were lung cancer, TNM staging, trust me, nobody does it. If you have done the answer correctly, good for you. If you have marked it wrongly or you have left it unattempted, trust me, it will not decide your rank because nobody reads TNM staging in such details as was asked in the exam. So it's okay. The exam is done, but it was not unsolvable. I have seen more difficult papers. It was definitely tough as compared to the previous NEET as well as the AIIMS, JIPMER and PGI exams which have happened. And lastly, short subjects are short again. The weightage was according to on the patterns on which it had been asked. Medicine, surgery, obs, gyne, maximum, followed by the other subjects, including my own subject, and the least ones were the shorter subjects, including forensic and anesthesia. So this was the general overview of the paper. There were long cases. It was USMLE pattern kind of questions. Many of you have not solved those kind of questions. So when you get a question with 6-7 lines, you are not supposed to read every word carefully. Yes, you are supposed to read, but you're supposed to read it thoroughly, fastly, and identify that keyword. Questions which are 6 or 7 lines long always have a keyword, the hint word. If you identify, you reach the correct answer. So the paper was framed in that manner. There were clinical questions in all the three parts, part A, B, and C. Even the anatomy, physiology, and biochemistry and pathology had clinical aspects to that. Systemic pathology was 2 times the general pathology. Hematology was very less. So yes, in that aspect, the paper was difficult. It was atypical. It was a bit different. And my personal feeling is it's deliberate on part of NEET because they are now going to make transition from NEET entrance to next exam over the next couple of years. So they are making the questions more clinically oriented so that students do not have a disadvantage. The future students don't have a disadvantage once they sit in the exam. So this was the general pattern of the paper. Then I'll be talking about some queries which you have asked. One common query was, sir, what was the ideal attempt in this paper? See, there is no such thing as ideal attempt. Looking at the questions, my personal hunch, I may be wrong, but my personal hunch is anybody with an attempt of 245 to 275 has done well. 245 to 275 is what I would mark in this paper. That does not mean ki if you have marked 220 or 210 or 225, you are out of the race, but your margin of error should be less. In case you have marked 280, 285, it's perfectly fine. I know a lot of rankers in AIIMS. Two of them just left a clinical seat in PGI. They have also given NEET exam and they have marked, one of them has marked 293, another has marked only 227. I'm not taking names due to obvious reasons, but what it means is in this paper, what will matter is how many correct you have marked and how many incorrect are there, the ratio between them. Even if a few things go wrong, it is not going to affect your rank. A rare retroperitoneal tumor or Monica, if you did not know about it, or some rare confusing option in B12 related questions, they will not decide your rank. Rank will be decided based upon the easy solvable things and how much your accuracy was in that paper. Another common query, sir, I marked some questions, but there was no time left to review and it got submitted. So I'm feeling distraught. Don't feel distraught. Don't feel sad. You marked the questions only because you knew that this was the answer. And usually I keep saying the first instinct is always correct. So if they got submitted, it might be a blessing in disguise. Third thing, a lot of students said, sir, many questions were marked wrong. I made a couple of silly mistakes. What will happen? It's okay. Couple of silly mistakes. Usually NEET entrance is lethal, but in the exam like this, even if your 3-4 easy questions are incorrect, one or two difficult or tukka questions will also go right. So you are not out of the race till the exam comes, till the exam results come. Topper will have 75 to 80% score, trust me. But the number of clustering will be less. So you will get a good rank, you will get a fair clinical seat, or a paraclinical seat, depending upon your choice, if you have done the solvable part well, avoiding undue negative marking. So this was one paper where there is no such thing as ideal attempt. And finally, three or four points I can make from this. And again, a disclaimer, my own personal hunch. There are no shortcuts to success. Concepts are the kingmakers. If your concepts are good, it is a one-liner, it is a clinical case, it is an image-based question, does not matter. Secondly, too much dependence on guides is counterproductive. It has been shown in this exam. In future, if you are preparing for the next NEET or probably for the next May or June exams, please stay away from guides. Do not throw them, but stay away from them. So because guides tend to rely more on one-liners, and when there are too many things, things tend to become diluted. Quantity is not always quality. You have 2000 things, you read 2000 things, don't revise them again. In NEET exam like this, you will not do well. But if you have done 100 expected things, 100 concepts well, revise them two to three times, practice them in MCQs, it would have been very, very good in the entrance exam like that. So what not to read is equally important as what to read. You will find a lot of sources there. There is a lot of information out there, guides, online things, and everything is there. Too much of information is there. Internet is there. Be smart. You're not supposed to read anything, read everything. You're only supposed to read what is important, practice that, and then move to the rarer things. This exam just exemplifies that. And finally, for the future exams, focus a bit more on the clinical aspects as well. Now, coming to what next to be done. See, you have two options. One, you start enjoying your life, which you should. Obviously, you should. and wait till results. And once the results come, then you decide what next is to be done. And the second option, option number two, you take a break for 3 to 4 days, visit your grandparents, visit your family, spend some time, indulge, sleep, eat, watch movies, watch web series, do whatever you want to do, gossip, send creepy messages to your crush. Don't do that, but if you want to do that, ki karna tha nahi, to do that in the next 3 to 4 days. After that, you start planning for May exams. MAIMS, MAIPGI, May, June, JIPMA, and there will be an IMHANS exam also coming up. So, because two things will happen. 3 weeks later, results will come. Either your results will be good. If your results are good, nothing to lose. Stop preparing and enjoy your life. Join your MDMS. What I did and what many, many students actually would do is they would grab a seat, take a rank, but they will take one last shot at AIIMS or PGI. You never know. You might just end up in AIIMS or PGI. So you have nothing to lose when you have a seat in hand. And because you started early, you will have an advantage over others. And if the results are bad, you don't have an option. You again have to sit. The next NEET, oblique next, we don't know what will come. That will come next January. You can't wait for so long. So giving May exams would be the only option left to you. You have already done a lot of preparation for NEET exam. You only need to modify it a bit and build upon it for the May exam. And since you will not be wasting the next 3 weeks before the results come, those 3 weeks are going to be crucial in you getting a rank of your choice. So again, it's entirely your personal decision. But my advice to you is, till this race is over, you are very much a part of race. Till you have a result in hand, do not rest. Take a break for a few days. Indulge yourself. Recharge yourself. Come back and start planning at least for your next exam. At least around from 11th, 12th or 15th January, you can start doing that. So give mind to the rest, to your body and mind. And all the best for your exams. End of the day, an exam is an exam. Achha result, bura result does not define you. You, the person, is more important. All the best for exams. Strategy post, I'll be putting in another video.